Welcome to LawPath Legal's education videos. My name is Damon Murdoch. I've been a lawyer for over 10 years in Australia. And today we're going to talk about software development agreements. What are they? When do you use them? What essential clauses should you have? Obviously, a software development agreement is when you're developing software. That can also be a web development agreement as well. I like to compare software development and web development to building. If you look at a building contract, it normally has several stages. It has the base stage where you lay your concrete slab. It has your frame stage where you build your timber frame. It has what's called a lockup stage when you put the windows on, the doors in. It has the fix stage when you put the carpets in and all the basins and everything else. And then you have a completion when you fix it all up and you get paid at the end. In a construction contract, you get paid at each stage. A builder will do the base stage. A relevant building surveyor will inspect it. The builder will then issue their payment claim, and then you pay the payment claim. Software development is very similar. And when you develop one, you should make sure you have a scope of works. That's the specifications of what's actually going to go into that software development agreement. Those specifications or scope of works should be broken up into stages, very similar to a building contract. You should have the stages not only set up in terms of what the works are going to be, but also when it's going to be done and how much is it going to cost. Because the worst thing that you can experience, or the worst thing my past clients have experienced, is having a situation where web development or software development has gone way past what it was supposed to be. It frustrates your entire business plan. It frustrates the timing of everything. And you don't have the time to be dealing with a web developer or a software developer going way past budget and way past time. So when you're looking at these software development agreements, make sure you have a clear, defined scope of works. Make sure those scope of works are broken down into milestones, into amounts, and progress claims. It's also important to look at engaging an independent person to have a look at those scope of works. And in our next video, we're going to get into more about the actual processes involved regarding software development agreements and a little bit more in depth about it. Thank you for watching our video. Make sure you subscribe to our YouTube channel. And for more information, visit LawPath's website, www.lawpath.com.au. See you in the next video.